In the previous video, we covered some basic functions of VS Code. In this video, we're gonna talk about semantic HTML. If you are using only div and span tags, then the HTML you write is not semantic. I will cover what semantic tags are and why it's important to use semantic tags. First of all, what does the word semantic mean? The word semantic literally has its meaning. In other words, a semantic tag is a tag that gives a meaning to the content of a tag. It provides the information that goes beyond just how they look on a web page. As the web technology is growing, it became important that the content of a tag should contain high value as information. So we developers have to make an effort on making the web with a useful form of data. One of such efforts is using semantic tags. High-valued content is useful for both humans and machines like SEO or screen readers for the disabled users. For humans, it's much easier to read the codes. So as for machines, search engines will be able to understand your content more easily, so we can improve search engine optimization. Then what are semantic tags? A semantic element describes its meaning both to the browser and the developer. A semantic tag clearly defines its content, whether a non-semantic tag tells about its content or not. A web page could normally be split into header, navigation, body, and footer. Body can be divided into sections, articles, and asides. Let's see what tags are in semantic tags and what each tag does. A header tag represents introductory contents, typically a group of introductory or navigational aids. It may contain some heading elements, but also a logo, a search bar, and other elements. A footer tag defines a footer for a document or a section. The footer element normally contains information related to documents like contact information or sitemap. Now, let's look at the tag corresponding to the body of the web page. The section element defines a section in a document. According to W3 schools, a section is a thematic grouping of content, usually with a heading. The article element specifies independent and self-contained content. An article should make sense on its own, and it should be possible to distribute it independently from the rest of the web page. The aside element defines some content except the content which is placed in a sidebar. Aside content should be indirectly related to the surrounding content. In addition to the tags introduced today, it'd be good to look at other semantic tags. Also think about how to improve the value of the web as information. Thanks for watching and hope this video was helpful. See you guys in the next video. Bye!